Hello and welcome to the first episode of the Bosch Rexroad Developer Series. You may have heard about it last year in November in Nuremberg on the SBS show. We launched our new automation platform called ControlX Automation. It's a revolution in the industrial automation. On the show, we noticed already a lot of interest into our new platform. But afterwards, we also received a lot of questions about it. So during that time, the idea was born to create a small video series where we could explain all the topics about this new platform. Today is the first episode. There are 10 more to come. Before we start, I would like to introduce myself. My name is Christian Zentgraf. I'm working now for 22 years with Bosch Rexroad in the automation field. And there I'm in charge of the technical support group. This means me and my team, we are the interface between our customer base and our development department. We go out there to carry out commissioning on site. We learn firsthand about new requirements from the market. We go back to our development department and discuss with them how we can implement that into our products and improve them, therefore, and also adapt them to new market requirements. Because of my technical background, some people said I could be a good host for this series. So we'll see. I will be with you throughout all the upcoming episodes. And for each of them, I invited an expert that could give us a deep insight into all the various topics. Today, we will tell you everything about ControlX Automation and the story behind. In episode 2, the focus will be on ControlX Core, from unboxing to the first project. Episode 3 will show you everything about the ControlX data layer and the data exchange between apps. After this, we will present the ControlX device portal to you so you can see how easy it can be to manage devices with ControlX automation. In episode 5, our software development kit is waiting for you. In episode 6, we will show you how your own app can be part of the ControlX world. A really important and frequently asked topic is security. So we will prove that an open system can be also a secure system. In episode 8, we'll give you insights about our REST interface and automated configuration. Episode 9 is all about the ControlX automation community, which you can join directly if you like to. In episode 10, we will talk about Python. And episode 11 will be a fantastic episode because it will be our Xmas show. And we thought it would be good to show you the magic of graphical programming. So I've talked enough now. As I said before, we will have one expert in every of our show. And since today's topic is ControlX automation, how it all began, I thought about inviting my dear colleague, Holger Schnabel.
Hello, Christian.
Hello, Holger. Nice to have you here. We know each other for quite some long time. I remember you were working on your PhD thesis. And I think during that time, I taught you most about automation. So would you agree on that?
Yes, of course, Christian.
Today, what makes you an expert on ControlX automation? What is your role in development? Can you please introduce yourself?
Yeah, first, thank you for inviting me to the show. I'm looking forward to start the show with you. That's a good question why I am the right expert for the show. But if we have a look in the audience, we expect there are mainly developers. And me in my role as a product owner for ControlX Core, I'm the right person to answer the question from developer side. I have experienced ControlX Core from the beginning, the heart of our platform, and therefore I'm the right expert for you.
Okay, so this means you were there from right the beginning. You managed the development. Probably a lot of people were throwing all kinds of requirements at you from our management, from our customers, right?
Yeah, that's right, Christian.
So Holger, tell us, what is ControlX automation all about? It? What were the reasons to develop this new platform?
Yeah, ControlX automation is a complete automation platform with which machines and systems can be connected in an efficient and easy way. What's new in it? We combined the requirements of the automation world with the IT world and the Internet of Things. The platform is based on a Linux real-time operating system, app-based programming, web-based engineering, and IoT connections.
And why did we develop this new platform?
We want to develop a complete new automation platform and not only to renew one of our components.
I can understand, because me and my team, we are the ones who have to make your ideas work at the customer side. And we see already those benefits of the new platform. I'm glad that we took this decision to develop it new. Tell me, when did the development of ControlX automation really start?
The ControlX core project starts in October 2017. I started with one developer, then we added some cross-functional architects and bring our ideas then to the development teams. The project start for ControlX Drive, another main component of ControlX automation, started a little bit earlier.
Would you say it was bold to develop the platform completely new and take this radical step?
Yes, of course. This required a lot of courage. But we recognized in the market the change of technology, and we recognized that we can't go on as usual. So software is becoming more and more the differentiating factor in the automation industry. And therefore, we had to provide our customers a completely new platform with which they can solve their problems for the factory of the future, for example, TSN, 5G, or artificial intelligence. And even for us as developers, it was the time to rethink and to let our visions out.
So were you allowed to do that, to realize your visions?
Yes, I gotta say that the management gave us a go for implementing the complete new automation platform.
So everything is based on the ideas of the developers?
No, absolutely not. The development of the new automation platform was also the starting point for complete change in mindset. There was no longer a separation between R&D and sales. We put our heads together, discussed the ideas and the requirements of the market and implemented it in our new automation platform. We were implementing it in an agile way. That means we are always building minimal viable products and provide it to our customers or to you as your sales guys, and you can give us feedback immediately.
The results and the feedback from the market is really amazing. Let me share one experience with you from the exhibition last year in Nuremberg. I have explained the ControlX automation platform to a young engineer, and afterwards he was more or less speechless. And finally he said, wow, this is so radical new and provides so many possibilities that all I have dreamt of. This was for me a really, really nice experience on the show. I must say I'm still excited how easy it is to enable our new customers to get started with ControlX automation.
Yeah, I am glad to hear that, Christian, because we completely focused on that our system is very easy to handle. Even our management can do it. No joking, it's as easy as you're working with your smart devices. And you out there are able to program ControlX Core in this language, which is best for your solution. For example, if you want to program an artificial intelligence app, you can do this in Python, and you don't have to use a language like PLC, which is not established for this kind of problem. And it is also important to support ControlX automation developers as they know it from their daily business. So we have created a community in which we can exchange the ideas, and you can directly get in contact with our developers, so that we can improve our platform with the help from our customers.
That's right. I'm also deeply involved in the ControlX automation community. It's a new way of exchanging information between you, me, customers, our development, and especially Generation Y. They're used to exchange their ideas on forums like that. Because it's for us an important topic, we have a dedicated episode on December 10th. But I would like to understand more precisely what were the weak points on our existing platform and made you think about a completely new concept.
Christian, what does weak points mean? We always developed very good products, but we developed them a few years ago, and everybody was thinking in closed system. With our existing products, we focused on high performance automation applications, and so they were very complex to handle and only for experts. Moreover, these solutions are poorly limited to automation technology, and so it was very hard for our customers to integrate the new requirements like artificial intelligence, TSN, or 5G in our platform.
How have those findings influenced the development, and how did we approach it?
We started with a complete cross-functional team of innovative architects out of the domains of hardware, software, and user interface. There we first developed all the concepts and validated them, and then we gave them to high-motivated development teams which developed the features. We also attach great importance to customer feedback. What does it mean? We implemented the MVPs, gave them to numerous customers, and get back the feedback immediately, and that feedback we directly integrated in our platform.
Okay. Can you give us an example and share your experience?
Yes, of course. The company SimCorp was our lead customer from beginning. He is in the food and tire segment, famous for his robots. So we could discuss all our architectural concepts with the customer, gave them the first MVPs, and get directly feedback. So it was a real win-win situation. We could improve our platform, and the customer was able to solve his future-proven application.
Me and my team, we can confirm this after our first feedbacks we received. So what was the focus during the development of the various features?
First, we had to focus on openness at all levels. Our second goal was to combine the requirements of the automation world with the deterministic and robustness of the system with a combination of the requirements of the IT world, like flexibility and updatability. Furthermore, the use of standardized tools and interfaces was very important for us. So in one of our next episodes, our colleague will explain you all about our REST APIs.
Okay, Holger, thank you for giving us an insight into the creation of Controlix Automation. It sounds to me like a big mind change and also a lot of trust and freedom that has been given to you. But by now, I think we know that we have picked the right path. Still, I have a few more questions, and I would like to ask you to answer them in no more than two sentences.
Okay, depends on the question, Christian. But for me as a developer, it shouldn't be so hard.
What was the biggest challenge for our software development?
One of the biggest challenges was the implementation of completely new concepts like the Controlix data layer, which provides the communication between all the apps of the system in real time and non-real time. And I don't even have to say any more words about that, because my colleague Johannes will present you the Controlix data layer in episode 3.
And what were the highlights to be celebrated?
My personal highlights was at the beginning of 2019, when we received the first customer feedbacks, and they were always positive and enthusiastic, and they showed us that we are on the right way.
And what was your personal product highlight? What were you personally proud of?
Of course, I'm personally proud of the development of the Controlix Core, which is the heart of our automation platform and which provides our customer a whole automation ecosystem, including App Store, licensing, device management, and security.
What are typical applications today, Holger? Can you give me two specific examples?
Yeah, but I can't promise you that I can do it in two sentences. The first application is the use as Controlix Automation as a platform. That means a customer who has its own IP, for example, a motion kernel for articulated robot, implements his own app and brings this app to our automation platform and uses real-time Linux operating systems, the communication technology, and the security from our platform. Second thing is the use of Controlix Automation in handling applications. For example, Schunk, who is the world market leader in clamping and gripping technology, uses our platform Controlix Automation to control his processes and to implement its own software on our platform.
I see what you say, Holger, because in our department we also work on several projects where the customers use the ControlX core only as a hardware platform with some added values like IoT or security. So this is for us very challenging because we have to deal with new topics. One last question for you. What is the next big thing on the agenda for ControlX automation?
Okay, unfortunately, we couldn't implement a productive solution for artificial intelligence. We only validated the concepts and implemented some prototypes because of a lack of time. But this would be one of the next big steps to also provide products out of artificial intelligence.
Okay, perfect. This is a really interesting topic for all of us. It was really fun with you, Holger, and I learned a lot. Hopefully the audience also learned a lot. But I have one very last question for you. During the whole episode, you sounded like you're a real software guy. Are you really sitting in front of the PC and do some coding by yourself today?
Christian. Well, I was just waiting for the question. No, of course, not in my role as the product owner, but I have a great team and they are miles ahead for me. That's why I was only willing to be your guest in the episode one. In the next episodes on this shares, they will set the real developers.
Yes, indeed. In the next episodes, we will have some real nerds here. We mastered episode one quite well. Episode two is up ahead. And I hope we made you a little bit curious and we are looking forward for your comments and your questions. The next episode, we will learn about unboxing the ControlX core and how to control a three-axis system. The next episode will be available from October 22nd. So please click on the subscribe button so you don't miss any of the episodes. Catch you on the next one to be two steps ahead.